So what's up guys, welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman. So yeah, let me show you what we're making today. This is the example we did in the last video. Whoa, it's a slow motion effect. Yeah, so this will be great to create a 2D version of Super Hot. The software I'm using for this example is Game Maker Studio 2. If you don't have Game Maker Studio 2, download it. I will leave a link down in the description below. So, okay guys, we're gonna aim for 50 likes for this video. Hit the like button and let's continue. Now if you don't have this example, there is a link down in the description below where you can download it. Now if you've been following the previous tutorials, you should have this spaceship, except for the thruster animation, which is really just one more frame. You can see that I just added one more frame to my spaceship. Okay, so we're gonna create a new sprite, and I'm simply going to fill this with green. I'm going to give it a C for code. Don't worry, we're not gonna do any actual coding. This is all going to be drag and drop. Let's make a new object, and let's assign a sprite. Let me position this somewhere off the screen. Let me double click on it. Let's add a new event, create. We're gonna create a global value. You can access global values from anywhere in the game, even if you are in a different level. Okay, so it's gonna be called Spark, and I'm going to set this, we don't actually need to call it a global. I'm going to set this to 1. Let's add a new event, draw event. Scroll down, and we're going to draw some text. We're actually going to print our global value on the screen. All you have to do is type the name of the global variable. So let's position it 200 on the X, 10 on the Y. Let's preview this. Okay, so our global value is displaying, fine. Maybe rename it to Spark is 1. Okay, let's add a new step event. We're going to increase our global variable by pressing a key. Let me drag out if key down. Okay, let's select our key. It's going to be spacebar. Drag out set global variable. Put it inside the key down. Now you don't need to type a global, just spark. Now for the value, we are going to set this to global.spark plus 0.01. Test it out. I'm going to press a spacebar, and you can see our global variable increasing. Now instead of plus, I'm going to go minus, and you can see that my counter decreases. I'm going to copy a key down, paste it. Now this is going to be the opposite. So it's basically if a spacebar is not being pressed. Let me change this to the plus sign, straight out. You can see the counter going up, and that's because I'm not pressing a spacebar. Now if you press spacebar, you can see the counter going down. So that works fine. Let me delete all this here. Let's add a new step event, begin. Let's make a regular variable. Let's just call it that HH. Let's add a new step event, scroll down, if key down, it's going to be spacebar. Let's drag assign variable. The variable is going to be HH. The value is going to be 1. Copy key down. And let's paste it. If the user is not pressing spacebar, then we're gonna set this to 0. Okay, so let's add more text to the screen. Let me just copy this and paste it. Let me change this to HH. Change the Y position. And this is going to be simply HH. You can see that HH is displaying now. I'm going to press spacebar. The number turns 1 when I hold spacebar. Okay, so let's return to a step begin. Let's drag a new if statement. So if HH it's equals 1, let's drag our global variable. It's gonna be the spark global variable. Target our global variable, which is spark. Now for the value, I'm going to set it to global.spark. It's gonna be -0001. Let me try it out. The number decreases, but it's kind of going very slow. Okay, so let's set this to only 2 zeros. See, hold spacebar, and that seems a lot better. Okay, so let me just copy this, paste it. So if the value is set to 0, so then we're going to increase it instead of decreasing it. Okay, so it's going up, and now it's going down. Let's drag another if statement. Now this is not a global variable holder, so you have to use a global.spark less or equals 0.40. When a global variable reaches that number, We're going to set the global variable. We're going to set it to 0.4. So let me copy that, paste it, and this is going to be the opposite. Now if our global variable is greater or equals 1, then we're going to set it to 1. Let's try it out. I'm going to press spacebar, and it should decrease all the way to 40. Let go of spacebar, and it returns to 1. So let's double click on the star. Let's go to a step event, and here's the speed of the star. So we're going to multiply this by spark global.spark. We're going to do the same thing for the small star. Let's multiply this by global.spark. Okay, so let's try it out. I'm going to let's press spacebar. Now it works fine, except for I don't think it slows down enough. Let's make it go lower. I'm set it to 20 instead of 40. Press spacebar. Whoa, and it looks a lot better. Okay, so that works fine for the stars. Let's do the same thing for the spaceship. Okay, so 5 multiplied by spark, by global.spark. Actually, just let me copy that so I don't have to keep typing it. Let's go to the right direction. Multiply by global spark. Okay. Try it out. Press spacebar. And you can see that the ship slows down with the starts. Okay, except for the thrusters. You can see that the animation for the thrusters doesn't match the speed of the game. So let's create a new step event. And let's find a speed animation. Set the speed of the animation to 1 multiply by global spark. Try it out. Press spacebar. Whoa! And you can see that the thrusters slow down with the rest of the game. How cool is that? It works fine, but I think the recovery time is a little too slow. Let me just increase it. Let's set our global variable to, let's increase our plus number. Try it out. Okay, so press spacebar. It slows down. And it goes back up. Maybe we can slow down the time faster too. Let's try it out. There we go. So let's try it out. Press spacebar. Whoa! And now we have bullet time. Now you can apply this to just about anything in Game Maker Studio 2. Alright guys, okay guys, if you like making your own games, make sure you hit the subscribe button down below. Okay, so that's it, smack the like button, and I will see you in the next video. Bye now.